Miss Artina? Why? Please, leave quickly. Otherwise, you will be dragged down into limbo, along with Fear the Great.
Are you serious? Then stop hiding and come on out already!
That's right. If you don't, Miss Artina is going to be in more danger.
Time is running out. There's no time to argue. Just come out here. We're not leaving until we save your soul.
Save me? Is that supposed to be a joke?
No, we're serious.
Miss Artina, please leave me. I have committed something so terrible. It can't be undone. A sin which I will never be able to pay off. It's best that I just disappear now.
Toughen up already!
Miss Artina!
You might think this is how you'll pay for your sins, but honestly, that's not enough. You're just running away from your responsibilities. Disappear now? That's the cheapest and most cowardly way out!
Miss Artina, you may be right, but how else am I supposed to do it?
I'll tell you how. Become a Prinny and pay off your sins!
A Prinny?
You say that what you've done can't be undone, that there's no need to undo anything. Don't worry about anything else. Just work diligently as a Prinny. It could take hundreds or even thousands of years to purify your filthy soul. However, every sin is repayable. No matter how long it'll take, I'll make sure you pay it off.
You will?
Indeed, that's the duty of a Prinny instructor.
I'll help you too, with super hardcore punishment, so you'll be able to pay off your sins faster.
Me too. I've already come up with some tasks for you. Like assassinating President Axel.
Disgaea wants to use you as a test subject for her new skills.
I'll prepare something more mentally burdening.
Everyone? Are you even trying to convince him to come back?
Well, he has the right to know the brutal path that's waiting for him. Not that I would let him back out now, even if he refuses to come.
Valvatoris, I've done so much to you. Yet you still do this for my sake? You'll make sure I pay off my sins?
Of course. Because I'm Valvatoris, the Prinny Instructor of Hades.
Valvatoris, I...
This is...
the last resisting power that's trying to keep him here, as the core of Fear the Great.
How persistent. And this was supposed to be created by God? Listen up, God! It is the demons who must punish the humans for their sins. Your turn ends here. Now leave the center stage. Your system is no longer needed.
Well, it took a long-ass time, but here we are. Final stage of the game. And, admittedly, it's not that easy. If you don't plan this correctly and your characters aren't really overpowered, which mine aren't, you're in for some trouble. Look at this. Fear the Great, a system that physically manifests malice to destroy the world. That attack is nuts. Collected hatred towards humans controlled by Fear the Great, it creates malice, which is used to gain more power. And look at these guys' abilities. Malice Des X. Cute. So his attack is huge range, 50% resistance to all elements, which sucks. Then we have Summon a Malice unit to the map on every turn. Those are the androids. Increases his own stats by 10% times the number of malice units on the map. So right now, his stats are 60% higher, I think? And attack increases by 20% per adjacent ally unit. That sucks. So yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep. His attacks are, stats are 60% higher. So basically, if I destroy this enemy right in front of me, his stats will decrease by 10%.
Take this.
And if I don't destroy any enemies, his stats will keep increasing by 10% every turn because he can keep creating more malices for me to fight. So I have to try to find a way to destroy these units on the side to lower his stats enough so that I can kill him in one turn, basically, with the heart cannon. Yet at the same time, avoid his attacks, pretty much. Because honestly, I don't know this boss's AI pattern. I don't know if he's going to stand right where he is or if he's going to come search me out. That's one of the. That's like the most important thing you need to learn about bosses in Disgaea game, the AI. You need to learn when they move, what makes them move, their attack patterns, etc., etc. I mean, technically, you could just throw someone to lift them up, but you know, that sacrifices a character, and I kind of need every character possible to take this guy out. So if you have a level like 135 Desko or whatever from just abusing level 9-4 or whatever, this fight's probably a bit easier. I actually liked the challenge. I thought it was pretty good. Also, for a trophy, if you want to see every seeing every skill in the game, you basically have to let him hit you with his special attack at least once. Just once, yeah. Pretty intimidating. But it's really cool. I'm like, holy it's like one of the coolest attacks in the game, and I've seen most of them. So, but we have some time before. I can't remember if the androids move or not. You know what? Let's. Maybe if we're really quiet and we let the enemy take their turn, we'll find out. They don't do anything. Which is both good and bad. If they don't move towards me, that means I have to spend that much more time getting towards them. And as you can see, we have another Malice unit. It's not that threatening by itself, but as you can see, they can appear anywhere on the map. And, you know, that just increases his own stats more. That kind of sucks. Ideally, you want to take out two Malices every turn, and eventually you'll get it down to maybe one or zero, and then you can take on the boss. But no promises that's going to work out so nicely for you. So, but abuse the shoe trick like mad. Because you really got to cover ground quickly on this map. And throwing, obviously quite useful also. And I'm being very hesitant, so I'm buffing up my defense and stuff so that, you know, just in case I do get hit, I can't accept Valvator's dying.
Here I come!
And Artina is good for casting Brave Hearts to, you know, increase your killing potential. So do I kill it in one hit? Not quite. Close, though. So we're gonna. I want to get just close enough to throw Fenric to have him finish her off.
You all ready for this? Here I come! Watch this!
You know, this is such an intense fight, and I still have plenty of episodes left to do after this. I think I'm gonna save Laharl for the extra maps.
Here I come!
This fight's so exciting! And again, like I remember, my archer does surprisingly good damage. There's only 1,000 less than Valvatore's, and she can attack from a distance. Defend, just in case he moves. And he doesn't. Pretty intimidating with that huge-ass sword, isn't it? So, I think Arkweed is strong enough by herself to just snipe the magic units on the side, but I'll send her, some backup.
What's this?
And if you're not within range of anything, you know, then just defend. Of course, I'm just increasing my elemental stats for the extra damage and protection. It really sucks that the boss has such good elemental resistances. And Zelda for increasing defense and stats, and also healing. Can't be too cautious. I actually like it when, prefer the malices to be close to each other so I can get rid of more than one in a single attack.
Here I go.
Now, I'm thinking the boss might have a move restriction where he only moves after a certain amount of turns, because with his Fear the Great skill, he more than likely can get close enough to attack one of my characters with this special skill. In fact, I'm pretty damn certain he can. So maybe he only moves if I'm within a few... Maybe if I'm within range for a normal attack, or maybe it's a set amount of turns. I don't know. I couldn't tell you. Now, by the way, there is a special... alternate ending, the true ending as they call it, you can get by on your New Game Plus, the level before this, not this one, because I made that mistake and I didn't get the alternate ending, but if you beat the alternate, the level right before this, the one in my last video, with a level of 500 Valvatores or higher, by himself. Destroy all the enemies with Valvatores alone, over 500, and then this stage will be different. Much harder, apparently. I think it has a few level 1000 Fear the Greats. I'm not quite sure. But, because I messed it up. I never got to see it. Oh, he's on the move. Bye, Zelda. At least it was only a single attack. And that probably killed her. Oh no, it's a Nick. She just managed to hang in there. But by all other accounts, she should be dead. So I'm kind of in danger with him. Especially since he's next to Desko and Arkwee, two of my better characters. So I'm going to sacrifice the Measle here and just hold him up. It's always the safest thing to do. But yeah, New Game Plus, level 500 Val, beat all the enemies on the stage before this, and you'll have the true fight, and you'll get to see the true ending, which is required if you want to get the trophy for seeing all the endings, which I'm not even close to doing, and I don't even know if I will. Not to mention, I don't even have my PS3 with the save data to do that. Alright, so how many enemies are left? There's 1, 2, 3, 4, I think, so Nemo's stats are only plus 40%. War of attrition here. I'm working my way towards it. I think Fuka can take care of that archer in the middle. Desko can help. I think I gave someone an extra pair of shoes by accident, maybe. There we go. She should just be within range for her. For her first special. Yep. Ah, nope, I'm one away. That'll do it, though. I forgot that I threw her. So now we just have Fuka help the other guys. Of course, now with Amiesel holding up Nemo, I kind of want to get my guys closer into the center so I can properly set up my ultimate chain. And yet at the same time, I don't want to outright kill him in one attack because I want to see his special attack. Blue canine? Yeah, fist. That's it. Oh! Ba-bum!
Not bad!
That's how you abuse the heart cannon, folks. Maybe you won't be such an embarrassment in the next dimension. Although the damage isn't quite over 9,000. I wonder when exactly our culture will get sick of that joke. Probably never. By the way, you know, they're re-releasing Dragon Ball Z for like the fifth time. This time on Blu-ray. I mean, it was on VHS, then they did DVD, then they did DVD box sets, then they did better DVD box sets, then they did in the Dragon Box, and then they did Kai, and now they're doing DBZ Blu-ray. Pretty nuts. And I guess you could say I made the mistake of buying the box sets because I thought, well, this is it. They're finally releasing the whole show. And, you know, it wasn't that expensive, but... to own the whole thing. I mean, it's a long-ass show. But apparently, they cropped the image, so it's not a proper ratio. Blu-ray, it'll be 1080. They're enhancing everything frame by frame, which sounds nice, and it'll probably be a bit cheaper. I'm a big enough fan where I probably will buy the Blu-ray. I kind of like Blu-ray. I mean, I got pissed when they re-released some Dragon Box with the non-cropped video. I'm like, fuck it, I'm not buying that again. But then Blu-ray sucking me in. Probably like how I bought Clannad and Clannad After Story about 2 months before I found out that they're re-releasing it on Blu-ray. I'm like, ugh, because that show is glorious. And it was naturally aired in Japan in 1080 already, so I really want to see it in 1080p. I love that show enough that I would get that again. Oh, just enough. Nice. So yeah, I should probably have Val kill those two and then start a combo on Fear the Great, and then what's ever left over he can take care of. Even with three shoes, he ain't gonna make it. You can throw Artina closer to Val, though. I really just want her closer for the... for the stat bonus to Val. I gotta make sure I kill these two. Oh yeah, that's overkill. Oh yeah, your stats are far less threatening. Still pretty good HP though. Alright, so let's get a combo going. Probably not the best choice, considering he's 50% resistant to fire anyway. See, that's actually a pretty decent combo. And a lot of my better characters are still safe and out of the way. This will probably do maybe 50%, probably a little less. Weekdays at 5. Weak sauce. Oh, he came back. Yeah, that was like a quarter of it. Oh, here we go. If anyone can explain the logistics of this attack, feel free, because...
You all deserve to die!
Megiddo. Yeah, but don't stop there. There's another! There's another! There's two more! It won't stop! Well, you only killed one of me. Now for the ultra combo of awesomeness. I think I used Fuka just to throw him closer. His stats might be improved by 10%, but I think it's more important to just outright kill him. Now, for the ultimate combo! There we go, almost right back to where he started. Oh yeah. That's right. Why not? I mean, my attack doesn't get that much greater, but he gets a much more powerful sword skill. Lower his speed. Or not. Meh. Really should do it from behind. I guess I'm lazy. Alright, he should get 4 extra attacks with this combo. So, will this do it? Place your bets now. That was gonna have to do about 2,400 damage.
I'll show you.
Not bad. Need about 12,000 more. And I didn't mean 2,400, I meant 24,000. Oh yeah, we got this. We got this by the ass. Sure like sending him in deep space. Woohoo! And there you have it. Well, everyone, that concludes the story. Enjoy the credits. And there... Oh! I guess I thought it might end after I killed the boss. Alright, so one more android. But yeah. Enjoy the credits, and there is an epilogue after the credits. Oh. Did. No. Okay, it did. I'm confused. So, watch after the credits, because there's still some stuff to see. Peace out.
Do you see now, God? This is the power of demons, angels, and humans. A power that's much stronger than yours. The ties of our camaraderie. Looks like you were finally released by the persistent hands of God.
I had no choice. You guys have done too much for me. Alpha Torres, you must have a lot of faith in Miss Artina.
What are you...
And you too, Miss Artina. You must have similar feelings towards him. Trust between a demon and a human. Well, I guess it's between a demon and an angel now. It's something that's very hard to believe for someone who's only seen the ugliness of wars amongst humans like me. Just one more time, I'll put my faith in this world again. Miss Artina, I don't know how many years it'll take me, but I will face my sins. And Valvatoris, I hope you'll guide me through it until my sins are paid off.
Sure, you've got it. I'll beat some sense into your head once you become a prinny in Hades.
Yeah. I'll make sure to be ready for that.
Rascal, this is a job for you now.
Me?
Who else? It's a death's duty to send souls to Hades.
But I've never reaped a soul before.
You can do it, Mr. Amizo!
Yeah, just be confident, but don't cut off any weird parts. Amizo, please.
Okay, I'll do it. Judge Nemo, your life ended a long time ago. As death, I will reap your soul.
Thanks.
In the name of Death Amizel, I hereby sunder thy soul from this life.
Judge Nemo, I'll see you in Hades.
Finally, the worlds were saved by the hands of the rebels from Hades, led by Tyrant Valvatoris. Valvatoris, Fenric, Fuka Kazumatsuri, Emizel, Desko, Artina. The names of these six heroes who saved the worlds were engraved into history to be taught for generations to come. On a side note, when Emizel was appointed to the position of Netherworld President, the name of President Axel was completely removed from public records and was forever sealed away in the darkness of history.
Mr. Vampire.
Hey, what is it?
I just felt like we haven't really had a chance to talk yet. I knew you were that vampire from back then, but I was too focused on my task and...
It's fine. I actually still can't believe that you're the same Artina.
Who would have thought that pure-hearted Artina would have become a money-grubbing woman?
Oh, please, give me a break. I told you I wasn't collecting all that money because I wanted to.
I know, but I can't help it after seeing all the excitement in your eyes when you were talking about money.
Mr. Vampire, you've gotten a little mean.
Calling a demon mean, huh? Your fearless attitude towards demons hasn't changed. Ah, you really are, Artina.
Mr. Vampire, I wanted to apologize to you.
Apologize?
Yes. To keep the promise you made to me, you continued to forbid yourself from drinking human blood. As a result, you lost your power and fell to Hades. I don't know how to express how sorry I am.
You don't need to apologize. I only did that because I made the promise.
Plus, I kept worrying about Judge Nemo, while you suffered the whole time because of that promise. As Mr. Werewolf said, I'm just a hypocrite.
Think whatever you like, but doing something is always better than not doing anything. Plus, by falling to Hades, I discovered sardines, a great source of nutrition. Actually, I should be thanking you for that.
Oh, Mr. Vampire, I'm trying to be serious right now.
I'm being serious too.
You really are, Mr. Weirdo. I'm glad we got to meet again.
Likewise. Now I finally get to keep the promise I made back then.
Yes. I ended up making you wait 400 years.
Right. As I promised, I shall only quench my thirst after I take you down to the depths of despair. Now, how shall I go about this? This will be most interesting.
No. There's no need to do that to me.
What do you mean by that?
I've already seen the depths of despair. When you were dragged inside of Fear the Great, I thought I had lost you. Your death. My knees were trembling with fear just thinking about it. All I could do was stand there, trying not to scream out loud.
Artina.
You have kept your promise. Now go ahead. Take my blood. And please regain your power, Tyrant Valvatores. My Mr. Vampire.
Thank you.